translating, go, sin no more. That, my friends, is mercy. That is the mercy of God. And that, my friends, is why I love God's mercy.
Oh, come on.
Excuse me?
I'm tired of this, man.
What?
You've been doing this all week.
What are you talking about?
All week it's been the same thing, and I'm tired of it.
Justice, is that you?
Yes, Mercy. It's me.
Oh, my. Why are you always following me around?
It's not telling the full truth.
Oh, gosh. What is wrong now?
I've been listening to something you have to say. It's time for me to talk.
Oh, is that what this is about? You want to have a chance to speak?
Yes.
Oh, I'll tell you what. If this will keep you from following me around and get you out of my hair, come on out. Please. By all means. Use the podium if you like. What's so funny?
It's really simple.
Okay.
When God created this earth, he made it with the foundations of his law.
Okay.
His law is perfect.
Okay.
They broke that law. They are sinners. And sin and sinners are a disruption to everything that God created. If God were not to punish them, that would undermine his authority. Not only that, but for all of the other worlds in the universe that did not fall, it would be unfair to them. It would also be unfair to Lucifer. They sinned, and they deserve justice. If God does not punish them, God is a liar. And if he's a liar, then he can't be God. And that's justice.
Are you quite finished?
That's all I have to say.
Now we're only telling you half the story. See that law of God you were talking about?
Yeah.
That law was written out of his love. God at his heart is love. And because God is love, the most outstanding attribute of God's love is God's mercy. Yeah, you know, you think it's just a trivial thing to be merciful, but I want to let you know, it's hard being God's mercy. Do you realize that in this big debate between the devil and God, God's mercy is what finally makes it so nobody has any excuse but to say God is worthy? But understand this, because of God's love, and his mercy, if he does not show mercy, he can't call himself a God of love. And you know what will happen then? You'll be right. You'll have exactly what you're looking for. You'll have a perfect universe with no sin. But people will serve God not out of love, but out of fear. And if they serve God out of fear, Lucifer is right. And if Lucifer is right, God is a liar. And we both know God can't be God and lie. So if he doesn't show mercy, he's not God.
That's it.
Sounds like it to me.
That's all you have?
It sounds like a rap person.
Let's go to the Word of God.
Oh, bring it!
I'm pretty sure it has something to say about it.
Well, what you got?
Romans 6, 23. For the wages of sin is death. You know what that is? Justice.
Now who's only telling half the story? You got to read the rest of the text, man. I keep telling you that. It also says, but the gift of God is eternal life. That is mercy. I got another one for you.
Want
to go for Romans? Romans 8:35. God says, who can separate? from the love of God. That's mercy.
That's an easy one. Isaiah 59, 2. But your sins, your iniquities have separated between you and your God. Your sins has hid his face from you. He will not show mercy. His face is hid from you. Oh, wait. Just in case. Just in case you need to hear it from the New Testament.
Oh, the New Testament.
The New Testament.
Okay.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 34. Think not that I have come to send peace on earth. I have come not to send peace, but the sword. You know what that is? Justice.
I know he didn't just go to the Gospels. He went to the Gospels. I've got one for you from the Gospels.
Bring it.
The Gospels. I've got one for you. Right. How about John 3? Oops, not 16, but 17. Boom! For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. That mercy.
So you're going to go with the popular verses.
Yeah, true, right?
All right, but let's go to the one that they don't even read.
Okay.
Micah. Chapter 6, verse 8. Are you ready for it?
I'm ready.
What does the Lord require of you? That you live justly.
Ha!
And love
mercy.
And to walk humbly with your God.
Jesus.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
I'm glad you are here.
So glad you are here. Will you please tell him?
You need to tell him that I am right. He's wrong.
God, how can life itself die?
No.
senseless. Why does God have to die? You see what?
This had to happen.
What do you mean this had to happen? Do you understand? This is God. How does God die?
And he died for all of them.
Wait a minute. Are you trying to say
this is what he was talking about?
This is his plan?
This was his plan all along.
This is his way to get justice and mercy to agree? Wait a minute. Hold it. Wait a minute. You mean the price for them to get into heaven is that God himself has got to die?
That's exactly what the plan is. He took their sins and he took their place and died for them.
Wait, you mean to tell me they can sit here and know how expensive their salvation is and continue to text their friends while God's blood still flows? You mean to tell me they can sit here and teeter on a fence trying to decide whether it's going to be cool enough to be with God when God goes through this? Well, if they can sit here and be uncaring and think it means nothing, then they can all go to hell. All of them.
Don't you see it?
See what?
If he loves them so much that he is willing to die for them, then we have to give them a chance at life. This satisfies me.
This satisfies justice.
This satisfies me.